Is it? Listen, apply, become more.
Listen, I pen songs for the perishing and parishioners, them hearers and them listeners, the home and the visitors. This is not a game, you can't tame or make it purty. They say the earth cursed, so our mouths stay dirty. It's mud on the track, a slug in your back.
Is it?
Hello everybody, how are you doing today? My name is Ono.
And I'm Debbie.
Welcome to the Is It Show.
You're welcome.
What's been going on in Nigeria now?
Hey! I'm so happy. We did.
You're happy that it's postponed.
I saw it coming.
Nigerians will break your head, though.
I saw it coming.
Not everybody is happy that this thing has been postponed.
I saw it coming, my brother. See, Valentine is going to still happen.
Okay, happy Valentine's Day to everybody.
In advance.
Yes, in advance. So, please have fun. Have a great.
And God help you if you spent that money. And you say it's PVC that you're doing to collect. God help you.
It's true now. A lot of people haven't actually gotten their PVC.
So you now come up with the excuse that you're going to collect PVC. And we'll go together. Okay. In fact, to make it easier, we'll collect the PVC in time.
Okay, that's cool. So we want to send a shout out to every Nigerian. We want to send a shout out as we await our elections. Please, let's not resort to violence. Yes. Let's do it peacefully.
Yes.
Exercise your responsibility and your right to vote.
Stay calm.
If you don't know who to vote for, or you're not convinced, please do not just, you know, it's a personal thing. Let everybody just go as their hearts, you know, where their hearts want them to go to. What's been trending this week? You heard about Bobby Christina?
Yes, so I heard, and it's very pathetic.
Yeah, it's very, very sad, you know.
Like, not again. And she also had hers in the bathroom.
Yeah, in the bathtub. The same, I think it's the same scenario where her mother, Whitney Houston, died years back. I think it's the same scenario that she was found in. You know, but our prayer goes out to Bobby Christina Brown.
Yeah.
We pray that you get well soon and that you're healed. And that you are healed of whatever pain or hurt that you must have been going through.
Amen.
And that the Lord himself, you would experience him personally.
Amen.
And also, Bruce Jenner, what's up with that man now?
I don't even know.
He wants to become a woman now at his age and at his level in life. I don't understand. I heard he also got involved in an accident, though.
Wow.
Yeah. So also, our prayer is with Bruce Jenner and the whole Kardashian family. We pray that you also experience the Lord.
Yes.
We pray that
understanding.
Yeah. We pray that you are confident about who God has made you to be.
Yes.
And that you grow in wisdom.
Yes. And to everyone who has also been traumatized, you know, who has not had closure from a bad experience.
Yes.
Please, I would like you to turn to God, and we still have God who is our Father. Even when our earthly parents, you know, fail us,
yeah,
we still have someone to run to. So please don't end your life. Don't do anything regretful or anything bad.
Yeah.
Just lean on God, guys.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so what are we discussing today, Debbie?
Corruption.
Corruption. It's a very serious topic.
Right? Very serious.
Okay, so what's on corruption?
Corruption is living in amongst us. Corruption has come to dwell. So we see corruption every morning. We're like, hi, what's up? How's your night? That's how we deal with corruption right now.
However, I think when we talk about corruption, when anybody talks about corruption, the first thing that comes to my mind is governance.
Yes, yes. I was going towards that. I was about to say that.
But I think I'm wrong if I think about it only.
No.
In governance.
No.
I think I'm wrong.
It's because they use that word a lot in governance. So it has, you know, when you think corruption, you think of, like you said, politicians, people in governance.
Yeah, but what is corruption, and what exactly are the examples of corruption that we need to look out for? Because obviously corruption is a negative thing.
Yes, yes.
It's a negative thing.
Yes.
But how do we understand, how can you make us fully understand what corruption?
To give very simple examples, corruption is running past the red lights. Corruption is driving.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Facing one traffic.
Wait, does it matter if I pass the red light, I drive past it at night or in the morning? Does it matter?
It matters. As long as there is a red light and your life is safe, except if there is someone chasing after you, in terms of self-defense.
Okay.
So that is understandable. But,
we
shouldn't run the red light.
So that is corrupt.
Something happened recently on that. That was on Christmas morning. I was heading to my parents' place, and this guy has been taking advantage advantage of when the light is on amber, it accelerates.
Okay.
Meanwhile, we got to Sandfield. Another driver was taking advantage of that amber. His own amber was coming to red. Our own amber was going to green. So this driver was taking advantage of amber to red to speed past. And ours was like, we're almost green, we're almost there. And it wasn't green yet though. We almost, as in our vehicle almost collided with the driver. As in, we're just a breath away.
So basically, like, doing the wrong thing is corrupt.
Yes.
Knowing what to do right, but doing it so that and thinking of oneself only
alone,
without all other people into consideration is wrong. It destroys not only us but even our environment.
Yes.
When I see people driving roughly, I see a potential of people harming other people's lives, not just their own.
Yes.
So that thing is corrupt.
It's corrupt though. No, it's corrupt.
Please give us other examples.
Corruption
really
is a parent paying for mercenary for his child to, you know, to pass an examination where he or she should be sitting for that exam.
No, but that child needs to go to university now. Will the child keep staying in the house?
Ross, he has to read and pass.
Okay, it's the child's duty, not somebody else's duty.
It is nobody else's duty, and it is not even a career. It's not a legal career in Nigeria that you can be a mercenary. It's not a career path that, yes, I'm a mercenary, so I'm going to be writing for people. And
so it's like the parent is dumping the child's responsibility on somebody else.
Yes, and they're hampering such a child's future because they won't even learn to take responsibility.
So that's a corrupt family.
That's
oh boy.
But that's a corrupt move. That's a corrupt move.
Yeah.
It's a corrupt move.
Yeah.
Sincerely, when I was in school, or when I was trying to write my WAEC, when I and all that, I didn't make my WAEC at once and I was almost tempted. My parents were never going to buy into the special center corruption kind of thing, mercenary kind of thing. But I was like, you know, these people are just going to do it and they get away with it. And but really, there's a long-term consequence.
Okay, I have one.
Okay.
I have one, and I won't say this one.
Yeah, say.
All right? And I don't think it's wrong for me to say it, but it's been burning on my heart.
Okay.
What of somebody who comes to a crowd of people and says that if you have 500 naira, pay 500 naira. If you have 2K, pay 2K and see what God is going to do in your life this week. I know you know where I'm going from, but I don't want to mention names. I'm just giving a scenario. What of that? How about that one? What do you think about
it? You know, when it comes to things of God, we're always scared to, you know, we're always scared.
No, me, I'm not scared. I will say it because a lot of people are actually saying it online.
Yes, yes. It's
an issue that needs to
be. It is saddening. For example, when they start from this point of view that, you know, God is going to bless you, just bring that 10,000 naira. And they begin to do it like it's
as if it's
an auction
not God's
sale.
Will that He blesses us already.
They begin to do it like it's an auction sale, like, okay, so that you won't fall out of this blessing, whatever you have. And I always know that they always come to that level. You know, when they start from the 100,000, 10,000.
So who should
but it is dicey. That is just dicey. It is, I don't know how to explain it. There are times when maybe, don't you believe in that, in launching into the deep for something?
Let me tell you what I believe. I believe that God loves a cheerful giver.
Yes.
All around.
Yes.
Whatever, and I believe that God will respect whatever you are able to afford.
So if there was this directive from God to say, you know, give God whatever you feel like right now, or whatever, you know, how will I say it?
Yeah, so I think it's left to the giver, not the person making the call, to say
that God is telling me 20 people to give 20 million.
Yes, I think it's just left to the giver.
Well, can't keep the prophet, everything here is vain. My job is oppressive, I strive for my blessings. The past is so corrupt, it's hard to ride with his message. Riches destroy the owners, the government think they own us.
Okay,
my
I have a quote.
Okay,
I had this wonderful congratulations to Lacrae.
Yes,
for
yes,
his Grammy
yes,
win.
Yes.
And every other person who won.
Yes, yes.
You know,
my frontline rapper.
Yeah, you know, do you know what he said when he was going to receive the award?
Yes.
He said, you cannot celebrate the gift without celebrating the giver of all gifts. And he made mention Jesus Christ specifically. Congratulations to you, man. Big ups to you, man.
Yes.
Also, I would like to say a big thank you to Gracie Bloom Events.
Yeah.
And Growing in Purpose Ministries.
The Grip Nation.
The Grip Nation. You can check them out on www.thegripnation.com. Check out Gracie Bloom Events at www.graciebloomevents.com. So is that all we have for today, Debbie?
Yes, so it's wrapped up.
It's wrapped up. It's
yes,
a wrap.
Yes. So just be good. By God's grace, we will all thrive above corruption.
Let's fight corruption, people.
Yeah, put on your punch.
Alright, bye guys.
Have a beautiful week.
Yes, we'd love to hear from you. Your comments, your feedback. Check us out on Facebook, Is It Show. We're on Facebook. You can email us at isitshow@gmail.com.
Yes.
You can also send a text message to 234-7065-886891. Have a great week. Bye. See you later.
Bye.
We can't talk about impending doom. What we got for rapping, no preaching people out of their shoes. It's cool. I be that dude we glue to our depravity until somebody free us from this gravity. Fly.
I wanna go.